is, how does it feel?
It feels always great to be appreciated. I think nobody would mind some sort of credit that you get for the performances that you put across, and it always feels great when people appreciate it, and you know, all your hard work gets recognized, and it just gives you a push to do better. I think it just gives you that focus, and it gives you the drive to keep doing better and keep experimenting and keep and not disappointing the people who have shown you that love.
I totally agree. I think that for me at least, you know, I'm so new. I look at awards as more of a celebration of everything that we attempt to do. And when everybody comes together, you know, once a year, and you know, they perform and they laugh and they joke, and then you know, they are awarded with that recognition, like Rahul said, I think it's just motivating and it's celebratory, and it, you know, motivates people to just keep doing their best.
So you both are the perfect example of bridging the two industries, the South and, as they say, Bollywood, up north. And IIFA also is about bridging continents and bridging hearts together, because it was one of the first awards that traveled, you know, to the UK, and since then has been traveling 12 countries, 19 years. And for us reporters, as many of my colleagues, they will say, it wasn't fun covering because we were working non-stop. So what is it like for you?
Video ban rahi hai meri.
Yeah, chasing and covering. What is it like at the IIFAs?
Neeche hi rehna.
I mean, for me, this is my
flash area. Yeah.
But when you're traveling, did you flash attend an IIFA before with
your? I never attended. I went to New York with my father because I love New York. But I wasn't allowed to attend the IIFA. So this was actually my first ever attending of IIFA. And I was, you know, nominated, and I was performing, and it was, you know, my first green carpet. So for me, it was all very new and very exciting. I had a blast.
What about you? Because you are one of the faces of IIFA in the South as well.
Yeah, so this was my first association with IIFA in Mumbai. I have been associated with IIFA in the South for the last 2 years. And, you know, I've grown up watching IIFA, and, you know, you've always seen it as one of those big award functions which is done abroad, lavishly, setting standards for every other award function across. And it's always great, it's surreal to actually be associated, because I remember when I was a kid watching IIFA and saying that I want to be there one day. And it's great, you know, and my this association specifically of the homecoming was also very special, because it was 20 years, it was in Mumbai, and it was my first association back in Mumbai. So it's great, it's always on the run. I have to be honest that I hate it when they come to record rehearsals behind the scenes, because you're sweating and you're probably rehearsing beforehand, and you really don't want to be shot at that point, but it's special at the end of the day.
And Sara, what were you? It was your first live performance where you danced so medley of your parents in. Tell us about that. Any performance anxiety?
A lot. But you know, I learned to deal with anxiety because I'm always anxious and I'm always nervous. Like, almost constantly. You know? But I think that as long as you channelize it positively, it's always just good. I was very, very nervous. I actually don't even remember the first, like, minute before I, you know, going on the stage. I was just like, I hope I don't mess up, I hope I don't mess up. And when I was on that prop, right before, you know, starting my performance, I saw Lakh in the first row. And I was like, oh my god, if I mess up now, it won't be fun. But it was all, you know, it was exciting. And it was special because, like you said, I was performing on my parents' songs. Because I was very clear that if it was going to be my first performance, I wanted to be special. Unfortunately, I don't have many of my own songs as yet. Here I shall aspire to do that. But, so my parents' songs was the next best that I could do, so I did that.
And also they say, with open arms by the industry and the fraternity.
I think that, you know, I'll be honest, the only thing that one can really ever do here is do their work with honesty and conviction, which is what I do. And I just have to say, and I've said this so many times and I'm going to say it again, that I think whether it's the industry or it's the media or it's the audiences, I think I have been given a lot more love and respect and appreciation than I truly deserve, you know. And I'm just thankful and grateful for that, and I shall continue to hopefully make people happy and entertain them, because that's what I love to do.
Awesome. And also, you know, in the South, what happens is that they don't like promotions very much. What is it like?
It's very different. I think largely, both the industries don't have too much of a difference. And of course, it's not about they don't like promotions, it's about the necessity of promotions. In the certain cinema, you're targeting one region. You know, if it's Telugu, it's Telangana, Andhra, if it's Tamil, it's just Tamil Nadu. And the percentage of people speaking that language is way lesser than a Hindi-speaking audience. And you're targeting the entire country then. So you have to cover your Bangalore and then your Northeast or your Calcutta. So I think that's the reason there's a huge, because the reach is larger, the promotion is much more in Hindi. But I think right now, like you rightly said some time back, that the gap is completely bridging. I think it's not about southern or northern cinema. Cinema has become universal, and people are watching as long as the film is good and it's giving them great content and great there are spectacle films that are working. So I think it's great for the industry on the whole, because so much exchange of talents and exchange of content is great.
So Sara, you're two young girls and you're on stage, as they say, you're going to carry forth the legacy for another 20 years. So IIFA 40th, you know, on the cusp of its 50th. So is it exciting times for young girls in the industry?
I mean, I definitely think so. I think that the gentleman who was introducing us also spoke about, you know, the importance of women and the way that, you know, they've been given a special role. The three of us here standing on stage, you know, and there's so many people here just listening to what we have to say and giving us the respect of, you know, recording us and taking photographs while we talk, which is great, you know. And I think that there are very many exciting times in it, both in the fraternity and outside. I think that, you know, women are being empowered, women are celebrating their empowerment, and, you know, they have the potential of being leaders in their own way. You know, I don't just mean politically or socially, but just generally for themselves, you know, in the fields that they are in, and you know, they're making their mark, and I hope that we can continue encouraging women in all realms, and you know, all of us together.
Absolutely. And I'd just like to add that women have always been multitaskers. You know, it's really, really nice to see that people are recognizing that now. And talking about it has really, really helped. And like she said, you know, it's a great space right now in the film industry as well, with the kind of content-driven films on women also being made. And that just gives us more to do with our characters and inspire many more to write films like that for women as well. So I think we both hope that, yes, great times ahead in the future.
Absolutely. And also, you know, with IIFA as a license, like, 20 years, and I remember the first IIFA when you had NCRDELHI and Sara Khan, and they've really set the bar over the years. And now it's, you know, you young torchbearers, but personally, your favorite live performer who's on stage that you get to see?
I saw that clip, and it's all the way, Ranveer, all the way, you know. I mean, he just completely kills it.
Yours is ready.
He's a fireball of energy. I've shot with him, and even his promo, right? How did he do that? I was in the first row when he was performing. It's still shocking to watch this promo.
Yeah.
You know, it's crazy. He's amazing.
And also, I know the IIFA green carpet gets everybody very nervous, because everybody wants to, literally, as they say, put their best foot forward. So who's actually, the two of you, cracks the green carpet code totally, other than your own selves?
I think everyone puts their best foot forward, yeah.
But somebody starts taking you really like, and you want to like.
I think Sonam always really tries to experiment and puts her best foot forward, and, you know, she is the fashion diva. I also like Anushka Sharma's style a lot. I think it's very classy and it's very elegant and it's chic. But I think it'll be unfair to pick two or three names, because everyone truly puts their best foot forward, and not only just red carpets or green carpets, it's just everywhere. Now, even for airports.
I thought you would say Ranveer Singh.
Oh yes, Ranveer is actually, I think, naturally just like that. He'll step out of house in like
I still remember when I was promoting Simba, I felt so betrayed by him, because I think Rohit sir told him, you know, it's a serious kind of film and don't wear so much color, and also I was going around everywhere dressed like this candy store, and he was like blacks and monotones, and I was like, oh, why are you doing this right now? This is not the time to act like this. Don't leave me. But I love his wardrobe. I think that, you know, that color and fun is so him. But it's not so much about, you know, I think it suits him because that is him.
Yeah.
And I think that fashion or style or whatever you want to call it should just be original, honest, and comfortable. You know, I think anybody that tries too hard is just not doing justice to themselves. Just have fun, life's short.
What's a, I mean, Now coming forward, I'm sure you girls also would be hosting the IIFA. So one more post you would want IIFA to arrange, organize for you. As they say, you have an invisible genie. So she has an invisible genie.
I'm having a blast working with her. And I think that it will be fun to see us, you know, do this film together and probably even, you know, host together. So that would be nice.
That's why Sabha's listening in. He is listening.
Next year. Done. Sorted. And performances.
And I would say I probably want Ranveer because I would want to see how much can I bring up my energy to, you know, what level can I match to his energy. I mean, he's just amazing. So it'll just push me. And it'll be a test for me as well.
Sabas is jotting that down. Okay, we've seen IIFA over 20 years, but was there any performance, any IIFA moment that has stayed with you? Any?
I remember this one IIFA. I don't remember the year. I don't remember anything. I was really small.
How old were you first?
Should not. But we are young girls. We are really, really, really young girls. But I remember this IIFA where Priyanka Chopra performed in an orange sari on a medley of songs. And I think it was in US, if I'm not mistaken. That's the only thing I remember. I think that was a fantastic performance. And I remember watching that and just thinking, one day, even I want to attend IIFA. You know, and I still didn't know if I wanted to be an actor. I wasn't sure. But I was just so smitten and just so in awe of the entire award function that I was like, I want to be there one day. And I think that memory has just stayed. And it's just nice to be a part of IIFA then.
What about you?
I think that it was actually 2013, watching Shridevi ma'am perform. Oh. You know, and I wasn't there live, but I've seen that performance. That she was just superb. I don't think that there's ever been a star dancer or actor like her. And I really, at the risk of sounding ominous, don't think that it'll ever happen either. You know? She was just like a legend to another level. I'm like the biggest Shridevi fan. And I really very clearly remember that performance. I think that's the one it would be.
So on stage, anyone's songs that you both would want to perform to?
I think I should
perform the performance first and then we'll make the list of performance. I think that sounds better, doesn't it? We'll talk.
So anyways, we are also 2020 is literally 75 days away. So your wishes for the new year and...
I think that, you know, last year has been an important year for me. You know, both my films released at the end of last year. And this year has been also an amazing year. And hopefully next year should be the same, you know. Both my films are releasing early next year, so I'm excited about that. And I just hope that it's a year filled with, you know, fun and positivity. And I hope that I can keep making people happy and entertaining them because it's truly my favorite part of my life.
Yes.
Well, this year was very special for me too because Tere Pyar De, you know, people saw me in a way that they hadn't seen me and it just opened more avenues. And there are a few films that I have signed and which I can't wait to announce, which will be soon. But those I start now. So they're all lined up for the first 6 months of next year. So I'm looking forward to a lovely, happy working next year and experimenting with those roles and a lot more love from the audiences. And that's about it. And making each day a beautiful memory.
And finally, as a journalist, I'm going to ask on their behalf also. We get very anxious and you're like red carpet, you know, spot milega kya nahi, ye footage milegi kya nahi. What are you all going through when you're walking on that green carpet or red carpet?
Arey, I love this question. You want to take it first?
Honestly, I don't, you know, with all due respect, I don't take it very seriously. Because I think that, you know, whether it's even audiences or media or journalists, I think what people are looking forward to and looking for nowadays is honesty and realness. You know, so I don't walk down the red carpet or green carpet thinking what's my best angle. Because that's not what you're looking for. My DOP will handle that on set when I'm shooting. Here you're looking to see what does this girl really have to say. You know, what is her opinion, what is her thought. And the less rehearsed it is and the more organic and fun it is, I think the more fun everyone has, you know. We are meeting people in today's day and age in the social media culture and all. We have such easy access to one another. I don't think it's about presenting the best and most correct version of yourself anymore. I think it's about being yourself and being appreciated for that. I think it's just less pressure that way and much more fun that way.
Yeah, completely second that. I completely agree. I think it's more than the actors really stressing about. It's the whole image of the fact that that we would be stressing, ideally. I think what people really want is, like what Sara just said, is being real. And that's why you love Ranveer Singh, or that's why you love people who are just honest and just blunt and real, you know, because they can connect with you. I think it's just about having fun. And for me, red carpet or green carpet is just about celebrating the films that deserve to be celebrated, celebrating that evening of performances, of the hard work that people have put together, and as an industry come together to appreciate each other. I think isn't that beautiful, you know, a year full of hard work and everyone comes together just to celebrate each other.
And that's what they used to say about IIFA. It was like the big fat Bollywood weekend. Everyone got together and had a party. Not the ones who were running after them, but the best IIFA tradition.
Well, you know, this year IIFA came home, so it was an exception to the rule. But I think the whole idea of leaving the country and taking the entire fraternity and celebrating the achievements that everybody has done together in different pockets of the world, you know, getting people to come from everywhere and just celebrating that, I think that was something very beautiful. But, you know, even this year has been special because they came home, you know, you have to go everywhere and come back home eventually. So every now and then, that's always welcome.
True. Yeah, absolutely. I'd say that's what made IIFA stand out. And more than everyone also traveling, I think the Indians in those different parts of the world also, you know, getting to see their favorite stars and being a part of their culture, I think is beautiful. And I think that's why IIFA is...
Exactly, and thank you so much. I mean, 20 years of coming to the IIFA, I've enjoyed it the most. It used to be tough but enjoyable. Thank you so much, and I'll ask Sabas to join us on stage.